What's up, guys? Welcome back to the channel. You may be in a situation where your iPad is frozen and there is no responding. Just like this, I'm now on YouTube and I'm tapping and sliding up the screen. You can see nothing is happening. The power button and volume button are not working too. Let me show you some real fixes. It's very simple. A traditional way is to force restart first. It may save your iPad's life. Check the model of your iPad. If your iPad is a home button, just press and hold the power home buttons together for about 10 seconds. Keep holding. Then your iPad will go to a black screen. Don't release your fingers until you see the Apple logo. It may take a little bit longer than a normal restart. For iPad without a home button, just press and quickly release the volume up and volume down buttons. Then press and hold the side button. Keep holding till the Apple logo appears. If the issue persists, try the next method. Method 2, repair with Reboot, no data loss. If your iPad freezes on a black screen or the Apple logo and method 1 don't work, I recommend you use Reboot to fix it, because it is very convenient and can avoid your data loss. What you need to do is to connect your iPad to your computer. Click Start. Then choose the standard repair that can maintain our data in the process. Here, Reboot requires you to download the matched firmware. Click Download to proceed. After downloading the firmware, click Standard Repair. If your network is fine, it won't be long. You can see my iPad is now restarted and is back to normal. Try to use YouTube now. It's always smooth no matter how I swipe and tap. Method 3, if you have iTunes on your computer, you can try to repair with iTunes. First, connect your iPad to the PC or Mac. Then you need to put your iPad into recovery mode. Unlike the previously forced restart, you don't have to lift your finger. For iPad without a home button, volume up, volume down, and then press and hold the power button. Keep holding until you see the connected computer icon. Click Restore here and iTunes will start to download the firmware. But this way may cause your data loss. For safety, I recommend you use Method 2. So that's all for today. Don't forget to give us a thumbs up if you succeed in one of the methods. I'll be grateful if you subscribe. Stay tuned for our next videos.